Big bucks, you got $5,000. Oh! One more whammy.
Look out!
Stop! Stop it, a car! You did it, Gene!
Stop!
Stop it, $4,000. Dave's yet to get a whammy. $5,000.
Today, these three players are after high stakes, but they'll have to avoid the whammy as they play the most exciting game of their lives. From Television City in Hollywood, it's time to press your luck. And now, here's your host, the star of Press Your Luck, Peter DeMarkin.
Hey, everybody, thank you. Hi, I'm Rand Rod, and everybody's here. This is a wonderful day because we're going to be giving away more money today. And, of course, we're going to avoid the whammy as much as possible. And let's talk to the three players who are going to be avoiding that whammy and looking for the big bucks, starting with our first player, Tom Olinger.
You got it.
How are you, Tom?
Hi.
Good. Hi. Tom.
Yes.
When were you born?
Halloween.
You're a kinky guy, Tom.
Yeah, I bet you better believe I am.
Now, you are a ham,
sometimes.
Tom?
Yes. Depending on what part of the pig the ham comes from. I got you.
Well, it's a daytime show, Tom.
Yes, I do.
Now, are you here to make some money?
You better believe I am. As much as I can.
Uh-huh.
And then some.
And then some. All right, Tom. Best of luck to you. And our champ, Karin Knudsen. How are you, champ?
I'm fine. Real excited.
You're doing... Oh, you do sign.
So you
can help the people who are watching the show.
Yeah. My deaf friends out there in South Dakota, I love you, and I'm going to win some money for you.
All right. You already have $15,450.
Yeah. And some of that goes to my little son, AJ.
I see. Hi, AJ.
Adam
great.
James, 10 months.
Yes, indeed. All right, Karin, good luck to you.
Thank you.
And we have Suzanne Cullenberg.
Hi, dear.
Hi, Suzanne. Where are you from?
I'm from Chandler, Arizona.
I see. And you used to do something with a living with your father. What is that?
I was a professional clown as a child.
I see. Did you give it up?
Yes.
I see. I'm a clown as an adult.
Yeah.
That's the difference.
I'm a clown to my 11-month-old daughter.
I gotcha. Yeah. And you're here to make some money.
You bet.
Well,
yeah.
let's dispense with the formalities and get right to it. I have questions, you give me answers, you get spins. That's simple. Are you ready?
Ready.
Here's a press your luck makeup hint. According to Ladies Home Journal, a lady's eyeshadow should pick up the colors of her what? Tom?
Her eyes.
Is the correct answer her eyes, her hair, or her clothes? Karin?
Her eyes.
Her eyes. What do you think, Suzanne?
Her clothes.
The eyeshadow should pick up the colors of my lady's clothes. That's right. Yeah, Suzanne got a spin. Look, who would have thunk it? You know, I figured it was eyes too, but that's why I'm up here and not making the money you guys are. Here we go. According to a USA Today poll, what fraction of Americans insist that the Soviets' boycott of the Olympics... Karin?
Half.
...of the Olympics won't diminish their interest in this summer's games? Is the correct answer one half, one quarter, or three quarters, Tom?
One quarter.
One quarter. What do you think, Suzanne?
Would you repeat the question,
please? Sure. According to a USA Today poll, what fraction of Americans insist that the Soviets' boycott of the Olympics won't diminish their interest in this summer's games? Is it one quarter, one half, three quarters?
One half.
One half. The fraction of people who say niet to letting the Russians spoil their fun this summer is three quarters. Oh. Yeah, most of the folks don't think it's going to diminish the effect on the games. No spins. Here we go with question three. They're an all-American treat, and no ball game is without them. Although, Karin? Although doctors say they're dangerous for young children to eat because they may choke on them. What are they? Are they hot dogs, ice cream cones, or popcorn, Tom?
Popcorn.
Popcorn. Took Tom a while, but he got the popcorn. Suzanne.
Popcorn.
The dangerous items for young children are hot dogs. Yeah. No spins for Tom. Karin goes to three. Suzanne stays at one. Hot dog. Here we go with the big fourth question. She dances, she sings, she's won an Oscar for acting, and according to a recent Time magazine cover, she's getting her kicks at 50. Karin?
Julia Prowse?
Who is this talented woman? Is it Juliet Prowse, Mary Tyler Moore, or Shirley MacLaine? Tom?
Shirley MacLaine.
What do you think, Suzanne?
Shirley MacLaine.
Yeah, the lady Shirley MacLaine. Tom gets a spin. Karin stays at 3, and Suzanne goes to 2. And that was the last question. We get a chance to turn those spins in the bucks. When we come back, hang in there. We'll come right back. Big board, $13,000 prizes, surprises, and a few whammies, so you want to be careful. The player who wins this round with the most money gets to play last in the final round. And guess what?
What?
Well, here's the story. You can pass your remaining spin anytime during your turn if you have a fear of the whammy, and four whammies put you out of the game. Whoa. So don't do that. Play with a few spins goes first. Tom, hit it.
Come on, you son of a gun, you. Come on, 1250. Stop
at the
I want to know that. Yeah. You can't plug it.
All right, she's got the moves. No dollars, one whammy, no more spins. Tom, let's go to Suzanne for two spins.
Okay.
No whammies. Stop!
Stop at $250. One spin left and you have $250.
Okay, I'm going. This one's Morgan. Here we go, big bucks, mega, mega, no whammies. Stop!
Stop at $1,250. $1,500, and you have first place, Suzanne. Let's see what champ Karin can do with 3.
Okay, I feel confident here. Okay, this is for my friends in the audience. All right, baby, and stop.
Stop at $300. Woo! Second place, Peter. 2 spins left.
I'm going to go, Peter.
All right.
Okay, good. Here it goes. This is for my husband and my baby, Randy and AJ. And stop.
Stop at $500, $800, $700 less for Suzanne. Everybody's going for first place.
I'm
going to. You want that first place,
I want that first place.
All right,
okay,
here we go.
Here we go. One more step. I can't even talk. Come on. And here we go. Stop.
Stop at a microwave oven. Valued at $550. You're at $1,350. Tom, no dollars. Suzanne, $1,500. You're going to advantage in first place. We're coming back with a whole new round of questions and answers after these words of wisdom. Hey, strict attention. Another time. Here we're going to go with 4 more questions. You're going to give me answers, and of course, you're going to earn spins, and you're all going to make millions of dollars,
mega,
right?
Mega, here we go.
According to the National Safety Council, more than a third of all bicycle injuries would be prevented if riders wore what article, Suzanne?
Reflectors.
Of protective clothing. Is the correct answer reflectors, knee pads, or helmet, Tom?
Helmet.
Helmet. What do you think, Karin?
I'll go with helmet as well.
Yeah, bicycle safety would be improved by 1/3 if the riders wore helmets. Yeah. Tom gets a spin. So does Karin. The continental United States has 4 time zones. 3 of them are Eastern, Central, and Pacific. What is the 4th called, Suzanne?
Mountain.
Is the correct answer mountain, plains, or Midwest, Tom?
Mountain.
Mountain, Karin.
Mountain.
Mountainia. The 4th time zone is called Mountain Time. Yes. And do you know why it's called Mountain Time? Yes! Yes, it's in the mountains. Boy, you gotta get up awful early in the morning, fool Karin, I'll tell you that. Oh yeah. You don't get a spin for that though. That was just a fun one. Here's another one. According to You and Your Wedding. Is that a book I missed, too? Is that on the bestseller list?
Yeah.
It's one of Mr. Mitchell's books. He reads all these books. According to You and Your Wedding, who rides to the wedding with the groom? Karin?
Best man!
All right. Is the correct answer best man? Bride's father or groom's father, Tom?
Best man.
Best man. Suzanne, what do you have to say?
Best man.
The groom is accompanied by the wedding by the best man. Yes. Tom gets a spin and goes to 3. Karin goes to 5. And Suzanne to 4. 4th question. All right, tense up. Here we go. According to the Census Bureau, how many workers out of 5 in the United States are women? Tom.
3.
Is the correct answer 3, 1, or 2? Karin?
2.
2 says Karin. Let's find out what Suzanne has to say.
2.
2. Well, out of every 5 workers in the United States, 2 are winning. And that means Tom takes a 3, Karin goes to 6, and Suzanne goes to 5. And that was the last question. These players are coming back. Let's find out who takes away all the money from the big board right after this.